Lovely people, and welcome back to Dordogne. We will continue right from where we left off. It's a very unique art style, which I really like. I also think we can finish it today. Thanks, and welcome back. Did you enjoy your coffee break? Fall down, but let's keep going up. Nice, I'm glad you did. Are you doing anything special this weekend?
This is my patch. No one's allowed.
You're the thief from the market.
I'm not a thief. Never see that word again. I'm just borrowing.
Borrowing? That's not...
They'll get their things back, and more, as soon as I find the Culobra's treasure.
The Culobra?
A giant dragon that sleeps at the bottom of the Dordogne. Guarding a big treasure.
Enough to pay back the people from the market?
Enough so everyone will like me. You'll see.
Do you need help? To find the treasure, I mean?
Hell. could a city girl help me find the Kulobo?
I'm an explorer.
Ha, don't make me laugh.
If I wasn't an explorer, wow, I wouldn't have climbed up here by myself.
Yeah, tell him.
Fine. Fine. Well, maybe I should test you.
Test?
There's a puzzle in here. Solve it.
Oh,
and
like
I'll
puzzle.
Decide if I can trust you, city girl. But first, catch!
I'll look at it after the stream tonight.
Mimi, are you alright?
Don't worry, I'm fine! What is wrong with... He's gone.
Let's meet at my secret lair tomorrow. If you solve my puzzle!
I'll show him! He'll see. Explore!
What a rude boy. I need that back, quick. Something fell in the river. Don't you want to look for it? It must be here to the left, somewhere. Ah, there it is. Are we leaving soon? Yes, time to head home. What did you do out there? Thief. Actually, I was still chasing the thief from the market. Really? He's hiding in the mountain. Is he with the resistance? I think he's just a common thief, no more than that. So, how did you find this boat? Pretty nice, isn't it? It was beautiful. It's beautiful out here. I'm so glad you like this place. I wouldn't want to leave, ever. You know, I used to come here often with your grandpa and your dad. Do you miss him? I miss him. It feels crazy to say that, but I miss him. Don't say crazy, and I think I understand what you mean. Your father is a... you know what? Let's just enjoy the moment together. Let's go, shall we? Yeah, I'm tired too. Great. This game is very pretty. colors and the style is very pleasing to the eyes. I forgot to buy eggs for tonight's dinner. I'll go to the neighbor to get some. I'll be right back. What are you going to do while I'm there? I want to do my binder. Really good idea, sweetie. Okay, it's binder time. Alright, what is that puzzle you want me to solve? Instructions. And stickers. Probably for this map. Let's read his little note. Step 1. Put the stickers in the right location. Oh shit. This is the house here. I see. Okay. This was here. First line, stones cannot fly. Stones and fly. Across the bridge, you'll find my house. Bridge and house. Found you. It's here, the thieves' lair. A baby could solve this, right? Now, I need to tell the thief I solved this puzzle. I should climb to the top of the tree and try to call him. Which tree? I think I found you. No way. Told you I was an adventurer. Well, well done. I'll be there tomorrow. We can discuss the coloring. Great. Cool. See you tomorrow. Good. Now I know where to go tomorrow. I ought to climb down now. I'd better hide in the map in here. I better hide the map in here, and then I can do my bind the page. Mimi, dinner time. On my way. What a day. Wow. The Games, Chapter 5. Sure, Nora left it right where it was. I'm worried about you. Come on, please. I want you to be happy. I love you. Love you too. Stuck in the metro, I just try. Just tired of the city, dreaming about running around in that cute little house of yours in Dordogne. Wait, it is your house now, isn't it? Process of finding out. Is there anything left here? Manuela, my name is Mimi. I'm 7 years old and I'm writing from the garden of my grandmother, Nora. She told me she was going to translate the letter into Spanish, a language you understand. I speak only French, even if my father wants to move to a faraway country because he thinks Paris is crazy. Sometimes he shouts at other drivers and I find it very funny. My grandmother Nora says she knows your parents and that you live in Mexico, a very colorful city. I would love to visit another city than Paris or Salad. I love your city already because it has an X in it and it's a letter I love. I must leave now. We're going to a cave with very old drawings. My father loves everything old. Maybe not Nora's house. Maybe my father doesn't like houses. See you soon. Maybe everybody calls me like that. Oh, we made it together with Nora. This rings a bell.
What?
There must be something interesting in here. Oh. Grandma should be calling me by now. Where is she? Alright. Sounds like Grandma is downstairs. And disturb her. She probably fell asleep reading that huge book she's carrying around. Well, time to go.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to
Bad Books in August
with my co-star Mimi. Today you're going to talk to us about a book you had to read.
Yes, Dad forced me to read a book for the summer while I was here in Dordogne. Problem number one, the book is boring. Problem number two, Grandma really wants me to read it.
Oh, come on, I'm only doing my duty. Why don't you tell us the story?
This book is about François, a boy who is obsessed with a tall, super cool student at a school called Moulin. François does nothing but follow Moulin while he does a bunch of cool stuff like running around and exploring a castle. Like I said, it's very boring. Eventually, Moulin gets married but leaves his wife.
Oh, not very nice.
Nope. Then François takes care of the baby. I don't know much about boys, but no boy would ever take care of someone else's baby.
What is your general opinion about this book?
I don't really understand what Dad sees in it.
It's a classic.
Maybe it's a classic because nobody said out loud how bad it was.
All right. I guess it's time to say goodbye to all our listeners.
Goodbye!
See you next time!
Okay. just go down here.
I was so carefree. Off to meet a 10-year-old thief. I feel like I'm remembering someone else's life.
Sure, if this is what we're supposed to do, but I imagine it is. This should be the right place, I think. I can't see anything. I'm gonna need something to light the way. Some of these fireflies, maybe. Should do it. Adventure begins. Hey, thief, what's your name? My name is Reno. Yeah, sorry, I just wanted to shout your name. Hey, are you still there? Why? Are you lost? Said the girl. place is huge. Don't get lost. You've never got lost. Never, I mean. No, never. That's a lie, and he knows it. Guess you met my flying friends. The thief. I am not
a thief.
Sorry, I said that. You don't know me. It's fine. I'm used to it now. That's amazing. Mimi, say hello to the Calobre legendary. Come on, Mimi, hurry up.
You were a great explorer.
I am. Wow, this is very, very cool.
I know. These are things I collected through the years, and you haven't seen anything yet.
Yay.
That's a cool lair. I've got good taste, right? Go on, keep looking. That's the dragon you want to find. I want its treasure. What is the Calobre anyway? It's a creature that sleeps at the bottom of the Dordogne River. It eats boats, sailors, fishermen. Scary. How big is it? It's as long as the Dordogne. It's gonna be hard to catch. Why don't you take the book with you so you can study the Calobre? That's a good idea. Thanks, Renard. That's the best spot at the whole of Dordogne. Because I need the best lookout to track the Colobrin. From up here, I can scout the whole river.
Something even cooler.
Cooler than this? You have books, fishing rods, and a wonderful view. This is truly remarkable.
Look at this beauty. I can cheat in class, and I can even store 10 phone numbers. 10!
No way. Whoa. Can I see it?
No, you can't. It's a gift from my teacher.
Sure.
But it's a secret. You can't say a word to anyone, okay?
You're very lucky, Amy. And I won't tell a soul.
Thank you, Amy. That means a lot.
So, I have an idea. How about we practice the scream the Colobre makes to attract it? Exactly. You read my mind. We should record ourselves so we can set a trap or something. That's even better. Repeat after me. So much better at this than I am.
This is so beautiful.
The first stars will be coming out soon.
To go. See you tomorrow!
Cause tomorrow we're hunting the Colobre!
Colobre.
Listen to yourself. It sounds like I was a monster. I worked, Fabrice. My God, who says that to their mother? What has Mimi got to do with this? She's independent and she's having fun here.
Hey, sweetie, you're back. How about some cocoa outside? Yes, I'll join you on the garden table.
Grandma, we wanted to have a discussion with you today about a difficult topic.
difficult topic?
Yes! The people of France want to know!
Want to know what? Mimi, I was sleeping!
It's 4 p.m. It's snack time! Where are the cookies?
The cookies?
You promised us cookies!
This is really good journalism. Waking me up from my nap and screaming in my ears.
Grandma!
Fine. Let's make some cookies. To the kitchen. And drop that mic. I'm gonna need your help to make them.
That was Mimi, extraordinary reporter, solving another snack crisis for my country.
Mimi!
Coming!
Okay. So much better outside. Yes, it's pretty cool to sit down. It's very chilly. We'd better make sure it don't catch cold. Thank you, Grandma. This scarf is so soft. So, you sneaked out today. I should be cross with you. But you aren't. As long as you answer three of my questions. Where did you go? Adventure. A cave. A cave. There are lots of them around here. Fine. But why did you go there? Have adventures. Yes, that's a word I love. More importantly, how did you feel about today? Important. I love that. I feel important to you whenever I'm on my own and living my own life. So, should I punish you? Let me think for a second. Grandma, please be nice to me. Of course, I'll be nice. You can explore and travel the world as much as you want, sweetie. As long as I know you're safe. Thank you, Grandma. Yes. Can we invite... how was your day? Slept all day, I think. I don't know why I was so tired. Probably that long book I'm trying to finish. And the main character, she is, oh god. The writer has never met a woman. Trust me. Chapter 6, The Picnic. That scarf, it has to be somewhere inside the house. The scarf could be upstairs in Nora's bedroom. Let's look. 6 missed calls. Wow. Bedroom. I hope the scarf will lead me to the box. So quiet. Looks like she had time before she... Let's find the scarf. This letter is a cautious final warning. Leave our family alone. The way we live is none of your business. We appreciated the hospitality and you took good care of Renault in the past. But your investigation regarding our relation is going too far. The next time you cross the line, we will complain to your academy. To the rector, even to the police. Renault is not your child. Take care of your own problems with your son before harassing us like this. Oh. When are you back? This weekend might be our last chance for Bellini. Here in the 50s, Dad was 6 or 7. That's a scarf. Renault when he was a kid. That's Edward, my grandfather, and Nora, and Renault. These must be his parents. Edward has Renault's watch. He probably gave it to at the center of whatever happened between them. Wait, I remember the watch. Nora and Renault.
Get back for lunch.
Oh, all right.
Don't you have to get home?
Nah, nobody cares about me. I'll stay here, I think.
Let's continue our search tomorrow, okay? Yeah, sure. Grandma? 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 Grandma?
What?
Oh. Can we invite my friend here? Please say yes. He's all alone, and he'll be hungry.
Yes, of course. Why don't we have a picnic outside? It's so beautiful. And we can make something easy to eat.
A picnic! That's a brilliant idea! Yeah!
Can you help me with the food for the picnic? Sure. I see Grandma walk by my new cereals. I miss them a little bit. Okay. Mom never lets me go get home. Don't worry, I'll guide you. I'm happy to introduce you to Renault, and I can't wait to meet Renault. He's a bit wild. I don't have any other friends like that. Wild. I hope he's nice. Oh, he is. Now, the secret to the recipe is lots of heat and lots of fat. The fatter, the merrier. Everything with salt and pepper. I'm glad I found a friend here. Not that I don't want to, you know, spend time with you. I understand, sweetie, it's normal to have a friend your age. That's good. I can tell he has problems with his parents. One more reason to invite him over. And I think that's enough salt. Into the frying pan. Boom. Still be warm for our picnic if we hurry. Follow me. Yes.
She put up with me and my ideas. I think she enjoyed it. It must be so refreshing to have someone like that in your life. Someone who says yes to all your stupid ideas, all your whims.
Mm-hmm. It's the same spot. This place is really cool, Grandma. Shouldn't you call for your friend? Right. I'll call him from the bottom of the cliff. Some pine cones so we can decorate the picnic. Yes, you'll love it. This is going to be great. Spruce. Easier because you want to do it. Simple as that. You must be right. My friend will be here soon. Let's get the food out then. Yes, we're ready. Mimi, he's here. Hey, hello. Renaud, this is my grandma, Nora. Hello, Renaud. I ran as fast as I could. You didn't have to. We brought some food, but why don't you take a picture first, Mimi? Oh. Nice one, and this time you're not all blurry. Before you called me, I'm pretty sure I saw something in the water. Did you scream? I did, but I think your scream is much better than mine. What are you hunting, kid? The couleuvre, of course. Do you think we've got a chance? It can't run away forever. Mimi and I could easily catch it. I've no doubt he'll succeed. When we catch it, I hope everybody will see me pull the serpent out of the water. Excited? I know I am. Of course, sweetie. Grandma suggested we should have a picnic with the three of us. Do you mind, Renaud? I don't. Afterwards, maybe we could play hide and seek. Or something else. We'll see, sweet. Is everything okay? It is. Yes, it is. Let's enjoy the picnic. Know each other. We do, sweetie. It's all about the watch. Talking about a thief and a liar. It's not true. Nobody believes me. Here, I don't care about the stupid watch. Stop. You shouldn't play with thieves. He didn't steal the watch. He told me he didn't. Why would you lie?
Nora knew Renaud. And he knew my grandfather. So something bad had happened between them. I see it now. I ran so fast, and for so long, I wasn't angry anymore. I just felt empty and sad.
Why? Why? I'm so sick of this family. I must calm down. I must calm down. The binder. Good idea, baby. Good idea.
Curious to know what actually happened between them. Alright, I am gonna end this episode here. I hope you enjoyed watching or listening in, and if you did, don't forget to leave a like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. But until then, stay safe.